Welcome back, children. We are continuing the sample question paper of class from chapter Heredity. Sixth question. Mendel noted seven contrasting traits in people. Name any two. Seven contrasting traits Mendel noted. You can write the stem height. Stem height is a contrasting trait. And it has two contrasting characters, we can say tall and short or dwarf. The second contrasting trait, you can say the seed shape. Seed shape may be round and wrinkled. Round is dominant and wrinkled is recessive. Like tall is dominant and short or dwarf is recessive. Like that. So we have studied two examples of contrasting traits Mendel noted in pea plant. There, like that, seven contrasting traits. You can see that. Okay, flower color, it may be, then position of the flower, the fruit shape. Okay, then position of the flower, that also we can include. So there are two important I have already told. Now third one, give any two special features Mendel selected for this Perovskite hybridization experiment. Give any two special features in pea plants. So we can say two special features Mendel observed in pea plant is that the pea plants are easy to grow. Unlike other plants, seeds are able to sow in the soil and to germinate and grow into new plants very faster. Second point, the pea plants shows various contrasting traits with different observable characters. Mendel observed in pea plant that the pea plant shows many observable characters, and also the pea plants are bisexual. As it is bisexual, self-pollination as well as cross-pollination is possible. Cross-pollination is possible even in bisexual or unisexual flowers. But being bisexual in pea plants, in pea flowers, he was able to perform self-fertilization or self-pollination. Okay? That's a reason why Mendel selected pea plants. And there are many reasons, other reasons, but you are asked to write two important reasons. Now, eighth question. What are the two types of male gametes, or why are two male gametes formed in a human being? They are two in the same or equal proportion. Why are two types of male gametes formed in pea plants? In a diploid organism, each cell contains, in a diploid organism like a human being, each cell contains two sex chromosomes. Male sex chromosomes are XY. Whereas in female it is XS. In each cell in diploid organism, not only human being, in all the diploid organism, each cell contains two sex chromosomes. But in human being, it is XY in each cell. During meiosis, what happened? This X and Y will be separated. During meiosis, the X and Y will be separated. Each one enter the separate gamete. Each one enter the separate gametes. Okay, when these gametes are random fertilized with the egg, you can see 50% will be male and 50% will be female. Okay, you got it? So in males, in diploid, as human beings are diploid organism, each cell of human body contain two sex chromosomes. In males it is XY. During meiosis, this X and Y separate. X and Y separate and enter the gamete, separate gametes. When they fertilize, these two sperms, X sperm and sperm with the Y chromosome, okay? And they fertilize with the egg in separately. Of course, you can imagine there are chances for 50% of male and 50% of female. And not only that, the gametes are 50-50% and the individuals formed also 50-50% male and female after fertilization. Okay? Right. Now, eighth question. Why are two types? Okay. Ninth question. In a cross between yellow flowered plant with a green flowered one, what would be the color of the X1 generation? Of course, what is the dominant trait? Yellow is the dominant character. So F1 will be yellow flowered. The reason, yellow is dominant over the green or recessive one, whatever it is. And the dominant trait express itself, and the recessive one will be suppressed. This law is called the law of dominance. Okay? Now, 10th question, taking an example, explain Mendel's monohybrid clause. Any example you have already studied and closed it. Tall and short, two plants with the tall and short. The tall plant with the homozygous tall, capital T, and dwarf for short plant with the homozygous short, small t. Meiosis takes place in each. Then after meiosis, the gamete receive half number of chromosomes. So in the first one, capital T in one gamete. And in the second parent after meiosis, you can see small t. When they fertilize, you can see capital T, small t. That would be the F1, that is tall. And when the tall plant, this capital T, small t, tall plant is undergone this self-pollination. And during self-pollination, four gametes are formed. Say, male sex organ contain produce two male one each one. N capital T, small t, then capital T, small t. Their fertilization results in capital T, then second hybrid in F2, capital T, small t, again one more, capital T, small t, and small t, small t. So this we can show in the cross, that ratio is called phenotypic monohybrid ratio, that is 3:1. So you are practiced in showing this sketch. Or what we illustration of the monohybrid cross. Okay? So you can revise that and learn. Thank you very much.